Hello everybody, this is T295 here, and welcome to Poppy
Playtime. Yes, I'm just stupid and blind.
Rich, where are they keeping the huggy boxes?
I don't know. I couldn't tell you. Remember when maintenance left in a sweep of this place?
No.
Exactly! Nobody in this stupid company knows what they're doing. Oh, I swear, I haven't seen a single box in its place since they started flooding the storehouse with orphanage junk.
Right.
I get it. It's a nice program and all, on brand. It's just hard to be happy about it when manufacturing's on our necks about it, because we can't find stupid hockey boxes!
Rich.
You're right. You're right. It's for the orphans. I just wish there were less boxes. Anything less would be more habitable. Is that even a word?
Yes.
Yes, I'm pretty sure habitable is a word.
Let me miss you. You can't do that when I'm not looking at you. I mean, you can, but... Come here, bub. Come here.
Now I'll go back to that.
I'll be right with you, Huggy. I just gotta figure something out.
My life. Gotta figure my life out. Oh shit, it's this way.
Don't kill me!
Wait, maybe I can get into the Hell's Gate. Nope. Oh, shit. What the hell? That was weird. How do I crouch? Again, Minecraft. Whee!
Well, this is fun before the hell happens. I wish I had a flashlight. Do I have a flashlight? No, no, no! Nope. I don't have a flashlight. Help me.
Where'd I go? Where'd I go? Ooh.
I was looking backwards and I didn't know where it was. What? Nothing happened. Go away. I can't reach it. Time to make a friend. Fostering happens. Adopt an orphan today. I wonder why this place went out of business.
Stella, what made you want to work at the Playtime Co. Factory?
Playing with toys when I was young was so magical. I could go straight from my bedroom floor to anywhere in the world. It was such a great feeling. And being able to work at a toy factory, somewhere that can provide kids with that same experience, that's a pretty great feeling too. Sometimes though, I really, really wish I could go back to being a kid. And it's weird, because adults are just kids, but older. I don't think anyone ever really feels like an adult, but your body just gets older and older, and then you die. Poof! Human bodies just can't stay young forever. There's things, though, like some trees that can stay alive even while being way older than a person. I mean, the oldest people to ever live are still younger than those. So I guess everyone is always young relative to something, right?
All right, I think we're getting a little off track.
Are we done with story time? Okay. Damage is a thing. These things don't save you from fall damage.
Damn it, full damage again. It's getting a little, clunky. Can you guys see that? Maybe I'm doing it with the wrong hand. I can't go any farther. Damn it. What the fuck? Fusion is real. Thank you. That took too long. Too long. I'm an idiot. I'm an absolute idiot. You know, I got to deal with Huggy Wuggy. Wait, how is there air coming through there and there's no vent there? That makes no sense. I don't like how the music went away. Uncalled for. Elliot Ludwig was a visionary, not Victorian. He set the stage for all the pause it, read it. I'm not doing this. I want to look at this. Y'all ready for this? Sorry. Nobody leaves without a toy. From Huggy Wuggy.
Just leave.
Fuck.
Isn't he wonderful? The fuck? Loading. Fuck you. Gotta do this all over again. I fucking hate this. Thank you. Just go, just go, just go, just go. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Screw you if I have to fucking do that again. It's fucking hell! Was fucking bullshit. So fucking boned! Why is Huggy bleeding? The hell is this place?
should have under no circumstances been left unaccounted for. That's why I'm making this log, so that the same mistake won't be made twice. Any future experiments will need to be contained and disposed of in a secure location. I'm not worried about myself. One breakthrough and I'll be back. We must forge onwards in the name of science, whether those who are beneath us understand it or not. End of...
Are you sure you'll be back? Or are you gonna be turned into a toy like everybody else and ripped apart? Bloodied and mutilated. No, run! Danger! Turn back! No, stop! Go back! Run! Kinda can't go back. No, there's nothing creepy about this hallway at all! Nice little flowers on the wall. That looks like a gate. I mean, it's not a gate. More like a cage than anything else, but... Can we play Dollhouse? No? There's nothing, ominous or scary about the red room with the red glowing lights at the end of the hall. Nothing scary about that at all, no. I mean, look at this, it's just so non-threatening, right? Don't look at me like that. Go away. Your eyes were closed. Go. I'm leaving. Your eyes were closed. You can talk. Well, that's chapter one of Poppy Playtime. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you want me to play chapter two when it comes out, please leave it down in the comments below. I really enjoyed this game. Even though it wasn't as scary as I first thought it would be, but it was still, tiny bit scary. I mean, it's not scary, it's not, but sudden jump scares, and when you are
going through a run-through and you don't have any freaking arms to do anything with, kind of puts you in a bad spot, doesn't it? But, like I said, that was Poppy Playtime. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, remember to like, subscribe, hit that bell icon, comment down below anything in general. And this is TT95, signing off. Bye, guys!